Yeah, family. Yeah, family. Right, cause y'all can tell I ain't playing right now. Y'all can tell. Y'all can tell I ain't playing today. What's going on, family? Checha, sensual vibes, divine chakras. I am living. Yvonne Amadou. Excuse me if I pronounced that wrong. Mahogany 742. Yeah, digital. Jukes get a girl. How we feeling, family? How we feeling, family? How we feeling? How we feeling? Eternal Kismet, Agape Amore. Venetian Star. Venetian Star. Like that name. Aquemini, yeah, you know the vibes. You know the vibes. Tamaya, what's up, queen? How we doing today, queen? We got Garden of Consciousness in the building. Yeah. Y'all could tell I'm in a different spiritual space right now. I'm in a different spiritual space right now. Right, it is elevators, right. I am Tiff J, I am Sinistar, the lovely. Alright? Listen, y'all, we got some transits to get into, and we about to see what the fuck is correlating with these transits and why we in this, why the energy is the way it is today. We about to get into it tonight. Hold on, fam. Let me just get this right. Let me get this right, because I ain't playing tonight. All right? So look, y'all, we getting straight into the transits, and I'm correlating how everything we see right now is an illusion. Everything we see right now is an illusion. Everything we see right now is an illusion. And we're going to break this shit down. Lady Dimois, I'm feeling good about to go up in ritual. Okay. Oh, yeah, we all tapped in the spirit tonight. Yeah, we in here. Nadi, Kim. What's good, Brody? What's good, Jace? What's good, bro? We about to... All right, let's get into it, y'all. So look. Look, Drea. Because y'all think I got my transits. Hold on. Let me make sure my shit... I get my shit right here. That play. All right. Off rip, let's get right to it. We got the Sun in Gemini, Moon in Virgo right now. Sun in Gemini, Moon in Virgo. So whenever we have the Sun in Gemini, Moon in Virgo, the Mercury energy is very strong. And I'm hot as hell too, y'all. I'm hot as hell. So y'all gonna see me get a little y'all gonna see a little every now and then. But I ain't stopping for shit tonight. How's the energy of tonight? We in a very communicative, logical space right now, y'all. But as far as the Sun and the Moon transit, but there's a lot of shit that we gotta talk about with Mars and Pisces, all right? There's a lot of shit we gotta talk about with the Sun squaring Mars. There's shit that we talk about with Venus squaring Mars and Pisces. All this anger, frustration, passion, root chakra energy, all up in our dreams, fantasies, imagination, in our illusions. And this is why I had to set the tone the way I did earlier today, because I had to let y'all know. Understand that there's strings being pulled right now. The puppeteers is going to work right now. The ventriloquist is going to work right now. All right? Them same transits we about to talk about, the people that got everybody in a motherfucking rage right now, that's what they're utilizing these transits for. All right? The same shit we coming on here doing, Mari, Ganja Goddess. The same thing we doing when we get on here is the same shit they doing every motherfucking day. How the fuck, what ritual, which transit, damn, is May? All right, what transit is coming in next month? Oh, this month we have that square that? Oh, perfect. Let's push this ritual out. Hopefully they react in this type of way so we could use the frequency vibration the world is in. Whether that's pain, sorrow, hurt, that's frequency vibration, that's substance, that's energy. And we gonna know how to manipulate that and make a ritual out this motherfucker. And this is what they've been doing for however long y'all could go back. This is what they've been doing for however long you could go back. But we're gonna get into it through the energies though. I ain't gonna sit here and ramble. We're gonna get into these energies so we could really understand how this shit manifests. Alright? Nah, I ain't on no lovey-dovey shit. I ain't on no lovey-dovey shit tonight. Turn that shit off. I'm always about love, but I'm more so in a spiritual warfare type of attitude right now. All right. I was trying to ignore what's going on, but I feel like too much of us are being consumed into something that we shouldn't even be relating to. We shouldn't even be relating to a lot of the shit we've been relating to this year. But all this shit is a learning experience, though. In the beginning of the year, when all these astrologers were saying Jupiter going into Capricorn, it's gonna be a fortunate year. It's gonna be an abundant year. Where? When we're looking at the global status, not your personal life, not my personal life, even though Jupiter and Capricorn affects everybody differently, where the fuck is the infrastructure looking like it's having any type of prosperous, abundant feel to it? This is one of the craziest years ever. This year going down in the books, and this shit is, the second half might be crazier than the first half. Second half of this year might be crazier than the first half. So let me, but look y'all, we got the sun in Gemini, we got the moon in Virgo, all right? So this is heavy Mercury energy, So this is why the past couple of days, all we've been doing is trying to find answers through communicating. That's all the fuck we've been trying to do. Relate to this person, see how they feel about that. Relate to that person, see how they feel about that. Sit back, watch the world, then go back into conversation. That's all the fuck we've been doing the past 2.5 days. Trying to make sense, Virgo. This, see, when we talk about Mercury, Gemini is the masculine version. Virgo is the feminine version. So we have the overall masculine energy, the sun, in the masculine side of Mercury. And we have the feminine, overall feminine energy, the moon, in the feminine side of Virgo. So right now we're influenced by both sides of Virgo right now. We're on the Virgo side. We're organizing details about what we're seeing. We're seeing how people are choosing to take certain detailed action right now. We're seeing how people are choosing to work on certain things right now in society. And then the sun sign wants to gather all them details, all the information related to others. In whatever way they think that they see fit to help them build more information. All right? So we in a super, these past 2 days, we just been up here all day. Especially if you a Sagittarius or you a Pisces. You Sagittarius, Pisces, past 2.5 days may have been rough for you. With the moon hitting y'all with these angles. And y'all picking up all these feelings and having to feel like y'all gotta think about all this shit. Cause you know Pisces and Sagittarius dealing with feelings, all right? So, look, yeah, when we talk about the sun and moon, all right, that's the energies that we're having. But the thing is, we're in the late stage of the moon in Virgo now. So we're gonna keep experiencing this influence tonight. But by the time we wake up, the moon is like 23 degrees right now. So by the time we all wake up, the moon will be in Libra. So all my cardinal signs, my Aries, sun, moon, risings. Capricorn sun moon risings, Cancer sun moon risings, y'all may wake up on the other side of the bed in the morning like, oh shit, the fuck, I don't feel right, I ain't fucking with this mood this morning, because the moon is gonna be opposite to Aries, so it's gonna be hitting Aries at a negative angle, it's gonna be squaring Capricorn, it's gonna be squaring Cancer, so all my cardinal signs, y'all gotta be careful when y'all get up out the bed tomorrow morning. Just know, like, all right, I gotta react and respond to more Libra energy, being more relatable. And you guys are really gonna find yourself, because this is a square in opposition. So this is a learning process for you guys, right? These next couple 2.5 days when Libra getting there. And it's not that, see, you guys, Libra's cardinal air. So this is creating new ways to deal with logic and communication. Cancers, Capricorns, Aries, they're cardinal, but they trying to initiate other shit. Aries trying to initiate how it sees and feels about some shit. Cancer trying to initiate how to fucking feel about some shit. Capricorn trying to initiate how to be practical about some shit. So this is why it's gonna be hard for y'all to get along with this energy, because y'all not naturally trying to just be so relatable, because y'all more so pioneer-like signs. Y'all have more of an initiate starter-like energy. It's almost a little bit hard for y'all to follow or feel like somebody's enlightening you or teaching you some shit as one, as a cardinal sign, all right? But when the tomorrow y'all gotta get with it, because the moon and the sun is in air. So y'all not being relatable is gonna come off very opposing to others, all right? Now, when we talk about so the moon gonna go into Libra tomorrow by the time we wake up, all right? Now, this creates a trine. This creates a trine between the sun and the moon, all right? Whenever we have two planets in the same sign, in the same element sign, the sun is in air in Gemini and the moon is in air in Libra. This creates a trine angle, and trine angles are opportunities, all right? Trine angles are opportunities. Now, everything I'm talking about today, y'all, I want y'all to put yourself in a mindset as if we the elites, Illuminati, secret families, JP Morgan, all the motherfuckers that run the banks on, it's all these secret society motherfuckers, all the motherfuckers we don't even know, because there's a lot of niggas we don't know, and we will never know, all right? Let's put yourself in a mindset like we them niggas right now talking about the transits, because that's what the fuck they doing. And that's why it's so easy for them to manipulate our motherfucking emotions and feelings. Because they be using energies that's in the fucking solar system to do that shit. Alright? So, this is why it ain't no fucking... It ain't cliche when I say stop paying attention to certain shit. It's literally that fucking important to not feed their energy. Listen, if somebody is hating on you... That's free energy. They're giving you energy. It's up to you how you gonna formulate that and use that substance, but you gotta be able to understand that. If your name, if your essence, your energy is being brought up in other places when you're not there, they giving your spirit all type of motherfucking energy. All right? So the more we gonna come look at our fucking TV screens and have a problem given to us, and then the same motherfucker who give us the problem, we looking for the solution, They juggling our energy. They just fucking all fucking sheep. They could just all come together right now, but they still stuck in racism. They still stuck in the skin color. They're not even black and they're not even white, but they still call each other that. But let's keep juggling their emotions and feelings. They don't know shit. They just sheep. When we gotta meet certain numbers, when we gotta meet certain motherfucking population control numbers, we just do shit like 9/11. We just do shit like coronavirus because we motherfucking can. And then when they start realizing coronavirus is some bullshit, we look at the transits and be like, oh shit, there's a lot of planets in here making some angles to rile up some emotions. These niggas ain't paying attention to coronavirus no more. We need some emotion right now. We need some attention. Fuck that. Man, I guess we're gonna have to make another black racist sacrifice again. I guess we're gonna have to broadcast some shit to get the emotions of the world back in our hands again. Alright? So family, like, I naturally am an advocate for people that look like me just cause of where I come from, just cause I feel like motherfuckers that look like me don't be fucking knowing about themselves. So my passion to teach people that look like me is gonna always be there. I don't need to get on here and talk about what I'm doing for black people. What I do for people that look like me is in my motherfucking action every day. Alright? But the thing is, I just can't get caught up in no motherfucking program. I'm sorry. I'm just too aware to look at things from a bigger perspective, from a bigger picture. I'm just too aware for that shit. And it's all good. Everybody got their time. Or is working on their way to understand certain things. But family, we are... Listen. We could break this shit down to race. We could break this shit down to motherfucking class brackets. We could break this shit down to religion. How much ways we gonna divide each other? Keep going. Y'all finish it. How much ways we gonna keep dividing each other? How much more ways? So, when y'all going on Instagram, and y'all turning your fucking TV on, and it's literally the same shit over and over and over and over and over, they're just trying to keep our emotions and feelings in the same place. That's it. They trying to stop us from getting on live and talking about the motherfucking energies so we learn how to spiritually get the, grow out this motherfucker. They trying to keep us busy. Motherfuckers don't be understanding that. They don't be understanding a lot of shit to, it really just be to keep us busy. It just be to keep us busy. Y'all think the government and the high ups give a fuck about some police? Y'all really think the government and the high ups, y'all think they give a fuck about no police? Some of y'all related to police. Some of y'all motherfucking related to police. Some of y'all have police friends. Some police is good people out there. It's a lot of Libra police. A lot of Libras manifest into wanting to work in the Justice Department and be police. You feel me? So, it's a lot of good motherfucking people that's police. But the culture that the higher ups try to influence the police system to have, so every new police person come in so they could try to infiltrate them with a certain mindset, like they don't even know what they're doing. They don't even know what the fuck they doing. They don't even know why the fuck they're trying to train each other to be sly and do certain things. They don't even know where that influence came from. So it's like, for me to sit here and keep going back and back to racism, slavery, the shit that happened to us in slavery. Listen, motherfucker, you go back there if you want. You travel back there if you want. When I was younger, my frequency vibration ain't like nothing about that shit. So I learned what the fuck I had to learn, and I keep this shit pushing. Like, y'all go keep traveling back there if you want. You, they broadcast something, they allow you, now, look, one thing happened, and look how much all of us, look how much history we pull out the textbook about everybody else that got fucking hurt. Look, one little thing happened, I ain't gonna say one little thing, excuse my motherfucking language. R.I.P. to that man. R.I.P. to his spirit. R.I.P. to him, alright? But another tragedy like this happens, and then we're subconsciously forced to look at all that other bullshit and get back to get soak all up into that frequency vibration. Alright? So, look, I'm getting ahead of myself, because we supposed to be talking about this through the transits, because the transits is showing us what the fuck is going on. So excuse me, family, because as y'all can see, I'm fired up tonight. I'm type fired up tonight. Because coronavirus is one thing. They out here killing motherfuckers. They out here offing niggas' grandparents. They're out here doing all type of shit. Fucking niggas' businesses up just because they trying to do whatever quota or whatever type of policy or whatever type of infrastructure change they're trying to do. All right? That was just part of the shit that they had to do what they really want to do. And it's like, I'm already looking at it like, yo, these niggas is going to hell. Like, these niggas is going to a fucked up place after this, because they really playing with niggas' emotion feelings on a different level. So at this point, I'm really fired up, because I really feel like it got to a point where people said, yo, like, I feel like people's spirits were picking up on the fact that coronavirus is some bullshit, and then this happened. And then I'd be so into what I got going on, family, that sometimes it do take me a minute to, like, yo, let me check the chances for a week. I naturally know where the moon be at, and if a sign just moved in somewhere, I naturally kind of be in my head knowing, like, all right, that's there. But I had to really go back and check the energies today, like, oh, shit. I knew I was going to see something. Whenever there's something like this in the world going on, it's going to be some shit to see in the stars, because they're always going to utilize certain transits to do certain things. Like, the government and the secrets, they literally have certain transits that they name it that. That they'll name it. Like, Sun Square Mars. We call this the Justice card. So every time Sun Square Mars come up, we gotta take justice onto something. But in their way. So if they feel like you're fucking up shit that they're trying to keep balanced, then they gotta take justice on your ass. Alright? On the sheep. That's all the fuck we is to them. Sheep. Whether you motherfucking white, black, whether you live in the hood or you motherfucking police officer. Alright? Now, obviously there's levels to how all these things correlate. Obviously there's programs. Obviously real shit happens out of racism. I'm calling it a program, but real shit happens out that motherfucker. Real motherfuckers die. Real families hurt. Over a fucking program that's been here for who knows how long. And this is something that has not always been here. So it's hard for me to jump on the 100% black side, where I'm here to support everything for people that look like me. It's just that it's hard for me to jump on that side when I know me jumping on that side 100% ain't really solving the problem. It's making me cause more of an imbalance. They want to keep us imbalanced, all right? They want to keep us imbalanced so they could keep us busy to keep doing what the fuck they gotta do. Now, all these motherfuckers is going crazy. Think about it. They wanted to have us quarantined, right? They wanted to have us quarantined. They wanted to keep us inside. Now, this happened. Motherfuckers is running crazy. I just seen Trump talking about if the Minnesota mayor or whatever don't get shit together, we're going to have to send the National Guard in the book. So then I'm sitting here like, oh, okay, I get it. Oh, so cause an uproar and then just give y'all a reason to move all type of troops through this motherfucker to really shut shit down. Because y'all want to act crazy because somebody died. So now I got to shut this shit down. Now we got to bring in all these tanks. Now we got to bring in National Guard. Now we really on shutdown. So it's like, you guys, we have to be able to ask why. We have to be able to ask what's the purpose, what's the intention. We have to be able to look at what's going on in the stars. Because if something crazy in the world going on, they're using it. They're using it for their advances. Just like how we should be reacting and responding to the moon chances every motherfucking week. They don't miss a day. They don't miss a motherfucking day. They don't miss a week. They don't miss a second. All right? They understand energy. They understand frequency, vibration. They understand spirit. They understand spirit. They understand that shit. Swear to God, them niggas is way more spiritual than... Yo. Shit. Oh, man. What's going on, everybody? Brittany Beauty, Crazy for Kiki. Lauren Ashley. Look, my husband a cop and he will help any... Look. But your husband... But look, because what's going on, Lauren Ashley? Your husband got to walk in the streets and deal with a certain perspective. Yo, family, I'm not even going to say her name. But one of my dear friends that I met through social media, through teaching astrology... felt like she had to send me a fucking message and apologize to me. She felt like she had to apologize to me. And I'm like, yo, who got you feeling like this? Who got you feeling like you need to apologize to me? When I woke up this morning, I didn't want no apology from you. Why are you giving me this frequency vibration? That's not that, you in an apologetic state for no reason. You ain't do nothing to nobody. You ain't do nothing to nobody. So all these programs got you questioning shit about yourself. Motherfucking white people that have the biggest hearts in the world. Do anything for anybody. They got them questioning shit about themselves. And they great people. So this shit is really an illusion, y'all. So let's get into it. So when the moon moves into Libra tomorrow, this is the opportunity between the sun and the moon. So this is an opportunity for all of us. This is a trine, all right? So a trine, we're having an opportunity dealing with how we communicate and relate to others. Now the thing is, whenever we have trines, this is an opportunity, but depending on what signs or planets is aligning, it's gonna show us what opportunities is gonna be presented. So, excuse me, I'm sorry. So, when we have the sun in Gemini, moon in Libra, Gemini's mutable air, Libra's cardinal air. So with this alignment, we're going to feel like we need to be relatable. We're going to feel like we need to push out ideas for people to think about. And the sun in Gemini is going to just go do it. So we're going to be creating opportunities. Once this motherfucking, I feel like a pastor. All right now. Now I said, today we're in some trying times. All right, Sister Ann, go ahead. We're going to go down with the collection plates one more time before I get into this last verse when we talk about this sun-moon transit. All right, Sister Ann's coming down with the collection plates. Woo, today has been a powerful service, y'all. Woo. Now, let me stop playing, y'all. But anyways, so... this creates opportunity, so we're going to be feeling like we got to relate some shit. You feel me? We're going to be feeling like we got to create an idea and push it out to people. And then it's Libra, it's Venus, all right? So it's dealing with balance. It's dealing with value and appreciating and compromising. So you're going to have the moon in Libra. We're going to be influenced like, yo, what's going on right now? what's going on right now, you're gonna be influenced to talk about some shit these next 2 days. We already influenced on being communicative, relatable, just having the sun in Gemini, period. So when we have sun and the moon in air, or when we have the moon transit Aquarius and we have the sun, this is super relatability. This is super, you don't want to feel alone this day. This is super, I got to get my thoughts that I've probably been holding in for the past couple days, couple weeks out. All right? Because it's how I feel. When we have the moon moving somewhere, it's how you feel. It's how... Josky. Yo, bring you a clown. Morrow's in for the collection plate. Oh, shit. Y'all got me feeling like the nigga from coming to Mr. Randy Watson. That boy good. But anyways, look, y'all. So, be careful, y'all. My Caps, my Cancers, my Aries, y'all be careful these next 3 days. Because people going to want y'all to be, everybody going to feel relatable. So when we being relatable about certain a frequency vibration or what's going on in the world today, y'all going to be the first ones to be like, Aries going to be the first one to be like, well, I see it this way. Cancer gonna be the first one to be like, well, I feel this way. Capricorn gonna be the first one to be like, well, this will make sense to me about the situation. All right, when the influences is really gonna be for us to, you know, feel where other people are thinking, feel how we're gonna cast the influence to feel like we have to communicate to others to build balance. All right, communicate to others to get our initial thought of how we've been feeling about something and express that. And let that Gemini sun take action and relate that, all right? So like I said, we just gonna be influenced to be communicating about everything that's going on. So it's like, you gotta be careful of what you're even talking about right now, because with what everybody's talking about right now, that's only keeping you in a certain frequency vibration. Period. It's only keeping you in a certain frequency vibration. Like, as insensitive as this shit sound, fucked up shit is happening every day. There's some kids kidnapped, being tortured right now. There's families dealing with family members that's about to die from a fucked up disease. There's somebody watching their fucking parent just being deteriorated from cancer. There's all type of crimes. This is from fucked up shit going on all over the motherfucking world. But when one thing is broadcasted that heavy, y'all know that was the... Listen, I know that was caught on camera and everything, but I bet if we had a camera for everywhere in the world, we would have been like, damn. That was just one of the millions of fucked up things that happened that day. There's something fucked up happening right now. So like, whenever I just feel like one thing is being broadcasted over and over and over and over, then it's like, oh yeah. This must be a ritual. This must be a program. There must be a certain transit they're utilizing. Period. All right? So, we want to look out for this opportunity with Moon going through Libra tomorrow, and pay attention to what people are talking about. Pay attention to what people are coming to communicate to you about, because depending on where you have Libra and Gemini in your chart, people may be coming to you with opportunities to support that area of life where you have Gemini and Libra at. But it's going to come through a form of relatability. It's going to come through a form of speaking, communication, all right? It may come through a form of you create an opportunity just by having conversation, and then something you've been thinking about, somebody simply says something, somebody verbalizes something you to make you think what you needed to think, to make you catch the thought you needed to catch about something you're working on. So the energies be that crazy, y'all. It be that crazy. Like, put it like this. Whenever the moon is transiting through a sign, you just really want to make sure you're doing a little bit of that sign. Like, just make sure you react and respond to that sign in some type of shape or form that day. Just it's gonna please. So the moon transit through Libra, make sure you're being a little relatable when somebody communicates to you, even if you really don't resonate. Like if it's something that you really is not, like somebody says something to you and they want your input on something, and like you could bypass it, or you could just give them a simple answer about something. And you, like, you could debate it if you want or whatever. Like, right now with that Libra moon, you just want to be relatable. You just want to, you want to just have an exchange with people. You don't want to be too caught up in how you see, feel, and think about things. Because whenever you too caught up in your own shit, the moon going through Libra, you always gonna come off like, damn, nigga, like, you mad opposing. Like, damn, like, you can't get them wrong. Damn, you don't know nothing about fairness, balance. Like, that's, it's just, even if you're not overdoing it, like, just because the moon is in Libra, that's the vibration of the world. So, people just, it's just gonna happen to be like that. It's just gonna happen to seem that day you're that selfish just because you don't agree with something because the moon is in Libra. Alright, yeah. So keep that in mind. But whenever we have the moon transiting somewhere, wherever you react and respond to that energy is always gonna help your day navigate quicker. So, Capricorn, Aquarius, Cancers. Capricorn, Cancers, Aries, my cardinal signs. Be careful. Be a little bit more relatable. Alright. I know it's hard for some of y'all. I know that shit hard. I'm a Capricorn moon. My Capricorn moon be getting mad at my son that my son always wanted to be fucking relatable. Capricorn moon hate that shit. Like, damn, do we have to talk to everybody today? Like, we have shit to do. Look, you've been texting on your phone and you've been reading DMs and doing this for the past hour. We ain't get nothing done yet. Like, so it'd be hard for your Caps to be relatable. It'd be hard for Aries to be relatable. It's hard for Cancers to be relatable when they feel the way they feel about something. Alright, y'all? So this is what you want to be careful of. Now, this is what I really want to talk about. I want to talk about all this energy in Pisces right now. I want to talk about all these energies in Pisces. Because that's where I see a lot of shit coming from. Where the fuck is my spliff at? Oh. So. Because I swear, these niggas play games. These niggas is like, you gotta think about it, family. Like, y'all gotta think about it, family. All right, yeah, we getting there. All right, so, but listen to this quick segue though. This quick segue before we get into this Pisces energy. You know, when we talk about planets transiting signs, you guys always have to look at it as something you can use. All right? I need y'all to understand that. Damn, I was fucking hot in here. Fuck, hold on. This ring light fucking beaming in my shit. Alright, so, Ritual Mama, my PayPal is wealthovertime@gmail.com. So, look y'all, so, Whenever planets are transiting signs, we got to look at it like, all right, this is something I could use. This is the energy I have access to, all right? Just like how I say the government, the higher ups, they're using everything the fuck we have access to. This is shit we all have access to, y'all. We all have access to this energy. Now, based off of your natural energies, you may not even want to access some energies. Based off your natural energies, some energies that may be opposing or squaring you, you got to learn from them. For the most part, any transit can be used in a positive sense. Just like how I say anything in your chart can be a positive. I don't care if it's a square or opposition. Turn that into your gift. Turn that into your power. You got a square between your sun and your moon. Your actions and your reactions don't get along. All right, you're going to be a powerful motherfucker once you learn to align your actions with your reactions. That's where any lesson, that's where any obstacle in life. Don't look at how hard it's gonna be. Just know you're gonna be a powerful motherfucker when you're done with that shit. Once you accomplish that shit, like that's it. It's just what you gotta go through. So, hold on, I just gotta get the incense lit, y'all. I be needing the vibes. All right, so look, Mars is in Pisces right now. Mars is in Pisces. Now, this is very important. This is why this is very important we talk about this, because whenever a planet is transiting through Pisces, this is the subconscious. This is like the end stage for the planet. That's what, like, that's the frequency vibration of the transit. Whenever a planet is transiting the Aries, it's transiting the first house space. So, just like how you have a first house in your natal chart, the actual solar system's first house is just Aries. When we say a planet is in Aries, it's in the first house. All right? So when a planet transiting Aries, this is like a new birth. All right? This is like a new birth of that planet. All right? So we have to keep that in mind. When the sun gets into Aries, this is a new sun. That ain't the sun y'all thought it was. Or at least, it may still be the same sun, but, because it actually takes, the sun be changing entities. I'll be forgetting how long, but when the sun changes to Aries, that place that it was at last year in Aries, this is a new place. This is a new energy. So everything is new. Everything is brand new in Aries when we're talking about transits, all right? So if I'm saying about the first house, Aries, then the 12th house, when we're looking at the 12th house, when we're looking at Pisces, a planet transit in Pisces, we're looking at it as the evolution. We're looking at it as the end cycle. We're looking at us dealing with the subconscious and karma and life after death. When we're talking about the 12th house. The 12th house represents your dreams, fantasies, and your imagination. And I tell y'all, when y'all go to sleep, y'all go to your dreams. Y'all in the real world. Y'all sleep when y'all wake up to this shit. This is the illusion we're playing out as the spirit. All right? So, when you in your dreams, you really seeing where you would go if you was to die. So that's another thing, y'all. If y'all having fucked up dreams or consistent fucked up dreams, then take that as, you know, your spirit is in a negative place and you got to do what you got to do to move your spirit in a positive place. So that's another thing y'all got to keep about dreams, y'all. A lot of the time, sometimes you pick up on a certain frequency vibration from a relationship, a situation in your life, an environment, and then because your subconscious has that tied to that frequency vibration, then you play out that shit in your dreams. But that's all your dreams is your subconscious. So if you whatever you see in your dreams, that's your spirit. Your spirit trying to show you what's going on, where is that? Alright, so keep that in mind. So, Mars in Pisces, what is Mars? Mars is our passions, goals, desires. Mars is our intentions. And when Mars don't get to meet its passion, goals, and desires, which is the positive side, y'all know what it's going to turn into. It's going to turn into anger and frustration. Alright? So look. When we have Mars transiting Pisces, all of our passions, goals, desires, intentions are influenced and pushed towards our dreams, fantasies, imagination, overall our subconscious, our emotions and feelings. That's very key. Y'all keep that in mind. This is the influence. This is what we're in. This is what we're experiencing right now with Mars and Pisces. Stimulated passion, goals, and desires within our subconscious. Stimulated fire and willpower towards things in our imagination. Now, this is the thing. Mars picks up feelings. There's two planets that pick up feelings. Mars and Venus. They pick up the feelings. What's going on, Shanae? Glad to see you in here. All right. So, when I say Mars pick up feelings, Mars and Venus pick up feelings. So Mars is picking up on your passions. Mars picking up on the things that you, that your passions, things that stimulate your passions, and also the things you don't like and you hate. This is what Mars picking up on. Mars picking up the shit you don't like, the shit you hate. Venus picking up on what you love. Venus picking up on what brings its pleasures. So keep that in mind. So when you have Mars in Pisces, Pisces is already dealing with the emotions and feelings in the subconscious. Variant the Mystic, what's going on, family? Blue Dream of Hers, what's going on? So you throw Mars in there, it's picking up the feeling of the subconscious. It's picking up emotions and feelings of things dealing. And the 12th house also deals with the collective subconscious too. All right, I like to say the 11th house, the house that birthed Aquarius, that house connects to the collective conscious, and the 12th house connects to the collective conscious. The 11th house does it through the intellect. The 12th house does it through the subconscious, through the emotions and feelings. So, when you put Mars in there, this is what Mars picking up on. Mars picks up a feeling of the subconscious in his imagination. And remember, Mars ain't doing no compromising. Mars ain't relating what it want to do to others. It's about setting the intention. It's about setting the intention and going right through it. So when you, if you, everybody that, even if you have Mars in Pisces or Mars in the 12th house, you obviously this is you. This is your frequency vibration. When you have Mars in Pisces or Mars in the 12th house, your intentions are set on your imagination. So whatever is in your imagination, you don't have the filter to think that is not real. With Mars in Pisces or Mars 12th house, Mars just sets his intention, sets his willpower, sets his passion on its imagination. So if in your imagination you think you're a spiritual guru, you're going to be a spiritual guru. You're going to be meditating all day, teaching, wearing crystals. You walking outside wearing that shit. Your presentation, everything about you, your subconscious, you already set in your subconscious and your intention. You already set the intention in your subconscious that you are this of your imagination. So when we be tweeting spiritual shit, we be saying if you wanna manifest that, you gotta be that. We ain't gotta tell y'all Mars and Pisces that. Y'all gonna go be that shit. Y'all just gonna go be that. That's why Mars and Pisces, Mars and 12th house, y'all could be great actors. Cause it's easy for y'all to tap into the feeling of something. It's easy for y'all, for Mars to pick up on the feeling of the subconscious and just be it. Like Mars don't play no fucking games. Mars just wanna do what it does. So if you have it in the 12th house, if you have it in Pisces, its intentions, passions, goals, desires, is all of that is pushed into the subconscious and imagination. So, on the negative scale, if you're a person with a fucked up imagination, if you're a person in a negative frequency vibration, you're always going to be creating illusions thinking you're that character. You're going to be creating illusions thinking you're this and that. All right? But if you have a healthy Mars in the Pisces 12th house, if you have Mars in Pisces 12th house, and you're in a high frequency vibration, then you're just gonna use that to be able to manifest something that you feel. You feel like you want to do something, you jump right into it. You be it. You get it done. Your intention is there. Your intention is in the subconscious. Your intention is in your imagination. Your intention is relating to your dreams. With Mars in Pisces or Mars in the 12th house. Alright, so this is what we want to keep in mind, y'all. Excuse me, hold on. So when we talk about this transit, this is why with Mars and Pisces, you could naturally one day just feel OD fired up, or like you could some for the past Mars been in Pisces like for what? For the past 2.5 weeks, I think. So with Mars and Pisces, there's days that we so passionate about our dreams. This today, like, we just been waking up out the bed like, yo, I gotta put in a lot of intention and work on the things on my subconscious, my imagination. You start with Mars and Pisces, you kind of stop looking at reality a little bit during this transit, cause you so tapped in into the subconscious right now. All right. Especially if you're a Pisces, all right? But now this is my thing, though. Now we about to get into the meat and potatoes and shit. So we know what Mars and Pisces represents, okay? Now, Mars is conjunct Neptune in Pisces, all right? Neptune is dealing with dreams, fantasies, and your imagination, and your intuition, and illusions, all right? So Neptune is home right now. Neptune is home in Pisces right now. Okay, so we all are being influenced to tap into our dreams, fantasies, our imagination, all right? And Neptune gonna be there for a while. So this generation, what happens from the starting, when Neptune finally, it could be a decade from now, when Neptune moves out of this shit, out of Pisces, when it's in Aries, we gonna be able to look back at Neptune and Pisces like, God damn, people did a lot of creative shit when it came to their dreams. People manifested a lot when it came to their fantasies and imagination. And I didn't think we was able to, as a people, we was able to creatively do what we was able to do in that last decade. Yeah, because you got Neptune in Pisces. Creativity was stimulated like a motherfucker. some people don't even know, Neptune is exalted in the fifth house. The fifth house is the house of creative expression, the house of creative artistic expression. Neptune loved being there. That's where it loved to be. That's where it'd be exhausting itself out because it goes so hard there. So Neptune is dealing with your creative source. So we have Mars and Pisces conjunct Neptune. So not only is our passions, goals, and desires relating to our subconscious and our imagination and our illusions, but it's next to Neptune. So this is even a higher influence of creating illusions within and relating to passions, relating to our goals, desires, and intentions. So when I look at everybody right now in a rage, I see a lot of the world is mad. That's all I had in my head before I looked at the transits. I was like, yo, the world is angry right now. The world is very angry. Obviously, we know why we here. But I'm like, where's the anger coming from though? I gotta pinpoint this shit. And when I see Mars and Pisces, all I'm seeing is, damn. The higher ups, they know with Mars and Pisces, they know right now we won't hesitate to place our passions with the things that's relating in our subconscious. So the reaction for us to be going crazy right now, this is what they expected. They expected to see rage within illusion, because this is an illusion. What we're angry about right now is a whole motherfucking bigger picture to this shit. We angry about something like, and not to minimize that man's death. Yeah, stick with me here. It's so much going on when it comes to spiritual warfare between the people and the higher ups right now, to the point that they're gonna have to continuously do coronavirus, continuously use their racism cards, continuously use Donald Trump, continuously use all the shit that they always use to keep our passions and our anger stimulated within the subconscious. And they know Mars don't take no time to jump into the imagination. So as soon as Mars pick up anger, that's it, it's over, y'all. It's over. As soon as the world pick up on anger, we not gonna check to see if it is an illusion. Cause we too lost in it. We too angry. It's like, what illusion? There's no way I could be angry about an illusion. I've just seen what I seen. That's why I'm angry. That's why you won't listen to me when I'm like, think about the people behind the scenes. Think about who's broadcasting this shit OD. It's hard to see that because you're so angry, and Mars jumped into the anger already. Mars jumped into the protesting character already. I just said this is why Mars and Pisces can be great actors, because they can just take their intention and jump into the subconscious imagination. So they knew it wasn't gonna. They knew it was gonna be a very small filter for thought after this situation. They knew it was going to be a fucking soft, a small filter for us to try to reason anything. It's like, oh yeah, they. It's been a while since we had something like this happen. And then on top of that, like, you know, they already been kept in the house for coronavirus. So yeah, the whole world, they just frustrated. But this going to set it over the, this going to set it over the edge. This going to tip the cup over. Because we got motherfucking Mars and Pisces. So the whole world's passions isn't within their imagination and their subconscious. So it won't take long once they pick up a feeling, they're gonna be real passionate about that feeling. They're gonna be real passionate about that feeling. So it's like, I'm realizing right now, I can only talk what I'm talking here, obviously. I would never go on my personal page. My personal page is pretty much dead to me, like. That page is like dead to me, y'all. Like, I would never talk about a lot of shit I'm talking about here, because people's hearts and people's emotions are not even fixed to be able to hear certain practical things right now. People want to hear shit dealing with their passions and their imagination and their anger. People want to hear fuck the police, let's go fuck this up. That's what they want to hear. That's what people want to hear. And Mars and Pisces is like, yeah, bring it on. Bring it on, let's fuck some shit up. I'm angry, let's fuck some shit up. Now, like I said, Mars conjunct Neptune. Neptune about illusions. So, it's about your dreams and fantasies, about your illusions too. So I just see the whole world got their anger stuck in a big ass illusion, and nobody wants to act, Nobody trying to see the bigger picture in this. Nobody trying to fight a spiritual war. Nobody trying to fight a spiritual war. The way we should have fought coronavirus is acting like we ain't know what the fuck was going on. When the government said put on masks and don't go to work and all that, everybody should have just kept going to work. Boston should have kept shit going. Nobody should have wore a mask. Then it's like when we act like that, they have to go out their way. Like, all right. Then we could negotiate, because then they're going to try. At the end of the day, they need your energy. They need your energy. If they need your energy, they wouldn't have to do all this stupid shit. They need your energy. They wouldn't have to do they wouldn't have to do all this quarantine coronavirus shit. We wouldn't have to have pandemics. We wouldn't have to have 9/11. We wouldn't have to have Rodney King. We wouldn't have to have none of that shit. All right. So this is what you gotta keep in mind. Why? Like, a black person could kill a black person. That shit ain't gonna be like. Like, it's just like, we know what's gonna happen when this shit happens, y'all. We know exactly, we know the pattern. We know the pattern when this shit happens. And it's been this long, and we still haven't figured out, like, yo, we the people. We fighting each other down here. We busy as hell dealing with racism down here. And this nigga's calling all type of shots. Like, the day a white man could be in the same room with a black man and they two notice that, it's over. But this program is strong. This racist program is strong. The Jesus program is strong. Religion programs, they strong. They strong energies. This is why they use them shits. How you think the fuck these niggas run the world? How you think they've been running the world for so long? We go to school to learn about psychology and all type of things in the media. I took media classes. Like, this is what confuses me. Like, I've been in college and have took media communication classes where they teach you about advertisement tactics. They teach us this in school. But when we come out in the real world, it don't matter. If it comes up on our Instagram, if it comes up on our Facebook, if it come up on our news, we sold. Oh, shit. Is on our TV, it must be what's true. It must be what's going on. It must be, because it's on the TV. It must be. You feel me? Now, this is the thing. We got Mars and Neptune and Pisces, so we got all this passion caught up in an illusion. And then we got the Sun squaring Mars. So whenever we have a square, this is a lesson. So right now, we have to learn to align our actions with our passions. And as you can see, the world ain't doing a good job with that shit right now. The world is not doing a good job with that shit right now. I feel bad for people that are losing businesses, getting their businesses fucked up, and they're not, and they black. Niggas is fucking up other black people businesses, fucking up black people communities. I do see police cars being burnt and shit, blown up and shit. But at the end of the day, like, what is that doing? What is that gonna do? What is that gonna do? What is that all gonna do? That's how they want us to react. They don't care about them. If a bunch of black people kill some cops today, y'all think the higher ups gonna fucking care? They think they gonna fucking care if we kill some cops today? All right? Exactly, Crazy Pakiki, passionate about the wrong stuff. About the wrong stuff. All right? So this is a spiritual, psychological war, y'all. I need y'all to be tapped into spirit and not tapped into media. Because as long as frequency vibration is everything. If you feel a way, it's hard to even think if you feel a way about something. It's hard to even think right if you feel a way about something. So that just shows you right there. That just shows you right there. You could be in class, but you got in an argument with your partner before you went to class. You can't even think straight in class. Argument, your relationship got nothing to do with class, got nothing to do with school, but that frequency vibration is strong. So it don't matter what tactic they're gonna use to get our frequency vibration fucked up. It's about the fact that they got our frequency vibration fucked up. That's what I'm trying to get us to understand. Once we notice our frequency vibration fucked up and it's not out, it's not because of us, it's because of some shit we seeing, because of some shit that's being broadcasted to us, then it's a program. It's a program. Just know that. It's an agenda. It's in a program. All right. Perfect. Now I know how to navigate. Because me being aware helps me to not feel certain things that I shouldn't be feeling. And when I feel certain ways because of how America want me to feel or how the higher ups want me to feel, that should affect how I relate to people. It affect how I think about things in my own personal life. It affect how I deal with my family. It affect how I deal with my relationship. And that shit ain't really got nothing to do with me because there's fucked up shit going on in the world every fucking day. But that shit is just broadcasted in my fucking face. And now I have white people that I fuck with coming up to me apologizing. I have black people coming up to me talking about what the fuck I'm gonna do. Fuck you mean what I'm gonna do? Fuck you mean what am I gonna do? Like, I'ma fucking be me and get spiritual on their ass. Like, I'ma tell my homies, get spiritual. Cause when you got spiritual protection, that's the best protection. Ain't no, listen. It could sound as insensitive as it fucking sounds. When you spiritually right, shit don't come your way. Certain shit don't happen. Like, it is what it is. Some of y'all that's walking y'all spiritual path and have that type of spiritual strength and and y'all confident in y'all shit, y'all know what the fuck, y'all know what I'm talking about. When you in a certain spiritual bag, shit cannot fuck with you. So it depends how you're gonna reorganize where you choose to put your feelings and emotion. You could keep them on. You could stay in the illusion if you want. You could stay in the Mars and Pisces illusion if you want. You could take your passion. You could be influenced to have your anger and frustration fall into an illusion, or you can have your passions, goals, and desires be pushed into creativity. That's the positive side of Mars and Pisces. But it looked like the world is in the negative side. It looked like the world then got influenced to fall into an illusion and have their anger and frustration caught up in an illusion from their feelings. Mars and Pisces. That Neptune there, make it more of an illusion. Make it more blurry to understand what's going on. Like, I literally hear people saying on their IG stories and shit, like, I just don't understand. Like, people don't, we're trying to make sense of this shit. We're trying to make sense of it on a racist program. We trying to make sense of it, like, looking at the higher ups. Everything get blurry when you add Neptune and Pisces energy in there. Shit get blurry when you got them energies there, alright? So you gotta be able to stay spiritually strong and shit like this. It's hard, it's tough. It's fucking tough. It's fucking tough, alright? But listen, y'all, we chose to come here as spirits. We chose to come here. Nobody forced you to come here, alright? So, the more you understand your ass ain't fucking, the more you understand that you visited, the more you understand that this is a low-ass world we live in, the more you understand that there's more beautiful energies, colors. There's, like I said, we're not even seeing all, there's so many other colors and frequency vibrations. We're limited here. We're limited. Just like an ant crawling on the floor, from their perspective, they can only kind of see so much from their angle and the way the size of their body is. Just like we only have so much of a perspective here. We can't see what the sun can see. We can't see what the sun can see. What sun and moon and Mercury, they have a different perspective. They can see more than we can. We can only see a perspective. The fish in the water can't see as much as we can see. They only have so much of a perspective. So this is what the fuck this shit is all about. It's all about mysticism, man. The government, the higher-ups, they move with mysticism. Nonverbal communication. They have codes. They have codes within their media. A lot of the times when they're bringing up certain numbers with coronavirus or deaths, those be codes. Those be codes. Those be random, not random numbers, but those be certain codes for them to communicate and send signs to each other within that realm. All right? So look, family, shit got me on the time. I'm coming right back on to finish these transits, all right, and take some questions.